Hello, how's it going, everybody? This is Etho, and welcome to another episode of our Let's Play series. What is this? What do we have before us here today? It looks like some kind of secret message. Oh man, what could it be? I have no idea. No, actually, I made it, of course. So I just wanted to demonstrate this to you guys. It may be a cool way you can hide messages in Minecraft. See if you can figure it out. It's kind of like a puzzle. Personally, myself, I don't like puzzles very much. I find them a waste of time. They're frustrating to me because I can never figure them out. But I know some of you really like puzzles, so I made one here for you. Actually, there's a whole genre of games based around puzzles, solving puzzles. They're called puzzle games. I know, it's crazy. All right, so I will say one thing, though. I messed up here on... Or I didn't mess up, but there's certain limitations in Minecraft that prevent me from doing the letter U. So this over here is a U, and this over here is a U. Alright, I could make it work if I made the key to solving the puzzle more complicated, but I thought I'd keep it pretty simple for you guys. So guys, last episode I got called out in the comments on something, and I kind of knew it was coming, I felt it. I brought it on myself, but basically a few people were like, Etho, can you do something besides redstone for just one episode, please? Like, do one episode not entirely based on redstone. Because lately I've been pretty bad on that. I've been doing nothing but redstone. We did a little bit of exploring recently too, but we haven't really done any building. And today is that day, guys. We're going to do some building just for the sake of building. Try to make things look nicer. I gotta say this though, guys. Like, I've been loving this update. This has been one of the greatest updates in a long time. I was thinking about it today. Like, what have we got as redstoners in this game since the redstone update? 1.5. I checked, it was over 3 years ago. What have we got? We got slime blocks. That was a big one. But besides that, we got, like, weighted pressure plates. Nobody uses those. We got activator rails. Those aren't super useful. Moonlight detectors, not super useful. Really, we haven't gotten too many new redstone things in the game, unless I'm missing something. So this update, I've just been, like, loving it so much, because we got the shulker box and the observer, two new things to play with. And I got so many ideas. redstone, though, a lot of you know I'm a redstoner at heart. I always have a redstone project I want to do. Building is more of an artistic thing. There's a lot of ways you could do something. And I struggle with that because I want to know the right way or know exactly what I'm doing. So I ho-hum a lot when I'm building. I try something. Don't like it, redo it, try it, maybe that's better, maybe it's not, try another thing. A lot of trial and error instead of actually knowing what I'm doing, I find. Ooh, I don't like this, we're too close to this fence. Should we fill this in? We have a hole here. Should we make this a lake or a mine or something? I'm not sure. Okay, so we got a little bit of a path started here. I just used gravel, and I mixed in some cobble and some andesite to give it a bit of variation. It's a bit of a weird spot. We have the village on this side and then the farmer field on the left here. And for some reason, I left a bit of a space between the two. So it's like, what do you do? What do you do with this area? Just put a path through it, I guess. Okay, something that might look cool is if we had trees on both the left and the right here. So I'm going to try cheese it to begin with, see if we can get oak trees to look good. Like that, and that's going to force it to be a tall oak tree. You want the stone on the right side because I think it's going to go lopsided to the left here because of this. We'll see. Let's see what happens. See if we can get the tree to grow. Oh, maybe not. yeah, it kind of looks heavier to the left, doesn't it, than the right side? There's more leaves on the left side. Uh-huh. So I'm going to grow a few of these all the way down here. Alright guys, so check it out here. So far, this has been pretty low effort. I just put in a path and grew some trees, and that's it. Right? And already, in my opinion, it makes this area look way better than the grassland we had here before. It was way more interesting, right? But now that we got this, the question is, how can we make it better? That's the question you always want to ask yourself when you're building. How can you make it better? Not so sure I like how low the leaves are here. Or am I being too picky? I don't know. One thing we could do, or try to do, is start making some droopy leaves. Kind of make it look like it's hanging a bit more. Could make it a little bit better. Also, we could mix in some other types of blocks here. So we have just green grass, oak, and we have the leaves, right? Let's mix in some coarse dirt too. See if that helps it any bit. So I got some coarse dirt here. I brought some soul sand as well, but I don't know if we're going to use that. Okay, very cool, guys. So check it out. I've mixed in the coarse dirt around the trees here. I started around the trees, and then it looked a little weird, to be honest. So I decided to mix coarse dirt throughout this whole area a little bit as well, and that helped it out a lot. Then I added the droopy leaves a little bit, not in the middle of the path, but on the right and the left of it, so on the edges of the trees here. Kind of makes it feel like the leaves are hugging you, you know, and closes you in a bit more. And it was pretty dark at night, so I added some hanging lamps here. Staggered them, of course, so we got one on the right, then one on the left, one on the right, one on the left. Halfway through, so it lights up a bigger area that way with fewer lamps. And now I'm not sure, what should we do? Should we move on? I wanted to try. We might want to add more to the bottom of these. I don't know. That's not something I typically do, but I've seen B00 do that, and it looks pretty good. Oh, man. You guys are going to have to forgive me. I just watched back some of the video, and I'm all over the place. My camera's moving all over. It's a building episode. You guys need to be able to see things, and I'm running around like a fool here. I'm going to try hold shift from now on as I look at things. But yeah, basically added the bottom on the trees here. I really like that. I think that helps it out a lot. It makes it feel way more organic now. And just added a couple logs at the bottom, not a crazy amount. And it's nighttime, so you can see the lighting. I'm really happy with the lighting. It looked a little weird hanging the lighting from leaves, so I added some logs above each of these fake ropes, you know. And the last little bit of detail we might do here is add just some leaves at the bottom, mix these in. Very cool. So I think we got this area taken care of. I put some flowers in as well and some mushrooms. I'm hoping they don't spread too much, but we will see. So I think we got this taken care of. We're going to move on now to a new spot. We're going to go from over here to over here. I was looking at this the whole time. It's like, man, I really put forth the effort on this fence, didn't I? Just a big plain fence all around this village. We should do something about that. Couple options. We could do a pike fence or whatever, like I did in the bandit camp in my modded series. So put logs down ranging from 2 to 5 blocks tall, probably. Kind of stagger them as well. And on top of these, probably going to put some slabs, either that color or this color. That way we don't get any zombies spawning on top and killing the villagers. Actually, you know what? If we just do a fence like this the whole way, it's going to be a big pile of brown. definitely like the spruce more, by the way. So I'm thinking we should also include fences every now and then between them so you can see into the village, get a little bit of green and whatever other colors are back there. Let's see, how cool is this? It's kind of cool, right? Still simple. Problem is we got a big area to cover here, so I don't want this too complicated either. Awesome. So check it out, guys. We got our brand new fence around the village here. Villagers are safe once again. This is a good example, though. We had a fence here. I didn't need to build a new fence. But compared to that stupid little oak fence, I think this is way better, right? It'll help the look of the area quite a bit. It looks good on the inside too. It's basically the same thing. And it's a simple pattern. Didn't take too long to do. So what I decided to do is just 2 or 3 blocks tall for the wood parts. There's always a slab over top. And either 1 or 2 blocks wide for the fence parts. And it kind of staggers back and forth as we go here. Uh-huh. Very cool. And you know how the path was too close to the fence before? I decided to move the fence inward, so didn't even have to move the path here. Uh-huh. Added a couple leaves on the side. I didn't do the whole thing, though. Only about half the village. Building takes a long time. I'm running out of time already, so we're going to have to keep moving here. Try to do some other stuff as well today. Should we keep going with this? I've decided let's build a lake here. Let's go ahead and do it. One problem is that dude over here. He is making things a little tough. At this distance, he's not getting me. But I think if I move closer, like up to here, he's going to start getting me. Maybe? Maybe not. I hear a lava pool. What is that from? Oh, right over here, really. Did not know that was there. Careful. Careful. Oh, looks like I might have actually gotten into here before. Redstone. Okay. There is redstone everywhere in this world, isn't there? So I put some coarse dirt on the bottom here, just so there'll be a little bit more texture once all this grass turns to dirt. So it'll be a mix of the two. I don't know if it's really going to be obvious. Can't really see through water anyway, but just in case. Uh-huh. So you can kind of see the coarse dirt, maybe a little bit, kind of, possibly. When you're in the water, at least. Not from above. Yeah, that was kind of pointless. Anyways, we got our little dugout over here, and we have the path running right next to it, which is a big no-no. In order to make it look maybe a little bit more realistic, we want to fortify the path with something. Maybe wood. We'll try some wood here. Kind of run that along. See what that looks like in just a second. But also, I want to show you this. So those mushrooms are spreading quite a bit. A little bit more than I would like. Like, we don't want them on the path. This doesn't look very good, right? So here's what we're going to do. This is a little trick for you guys, in case you've ever had this problem too. Mushrooms check a 9x9x3 area if there's any more of the same type of mushroom in that. If there's less than 5, then it will spread. Okay, so basically it checks 4 blocks away from itself. 1 block above, 1 block below. So we can hide some red mushrooms here, probably. Get them underneath here, for example. We can hide 2 there pretty easily. Maybe some under the tree. And if we do that, it's going to stop it from spreading, and it won't go on the path like it was there. Yeah, put a couple more over here. Although, wait a second. So this one's going to check if there's 5 within the area. It'll go 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that's still within range. So I think that'll work. Ho-ho-ho-ho, no. We have a crisis situation here, people. It's a step up, step down, typical problem we all face. How do we deal with it? I don't know. This is a couple examples of how I usually do step up, step downs. I always use slabs. I don't like using stairs for these. Slabs are a little bit more gradual, I find. Young Etho probably would have done something like this, or you just put the slabs like that. I've kind of learned, though, I don't like it when the edges are next to air blocks. Like, I always want a block on the left and right of those, if possible. Another rule I usually follow is I don't like to make a U shape when doing a step up, a step down, if I can help it. So in this case, what would I do? That's a question for you. I think I would go in another block here at least, and like then you can do that. You also don't want it to be straight. Straight is boring. You want it to look organic. So probably go like this. Switch this over to gravel. There. Step up, step down. We got it. All right, so this is another interesting thing I did not expect to happen. So I put some slabs along the side here. This doesn't look right, right? You know why it doesn't look right? It's because our eyes like to detect patterns. And we have an offset pattern here. We have grass on the right side, none on the left side. So it looks weird, right? I need to get at least one block of grass on this left side here for it to look okay. Also, if we look over here, I don't like the oak wood at all. We should use the dark oak. Still doesn't look quite right, does it? Something is off. It looks better. I would say it looks better. I tried it with the slabs. That doesn't look very good. I tried it with fences here. Looks better with the fences, but again, it still doesn't look quite good. Possibly we need to mirror what we did on this side to this side. Also, I think the path is just wrong. Yeah. Yeah, let's shave off the gravel over here a little bit. Add it to over here. We want it to look like it's winding, and it's just a little bit crazy looking at the moment. No, it's still no good. Let's try a little bit more. Push it over here. Oh! And we got some other problems. Okay. Fill this in. Again, a lot of trial and error, just seeing if things work or not. I think it's getting better. Problem is, it's only two blocks wide there now. No, it's not working. And there we go. So a little bit of trial and error. I think that looks a lot better now, though. Right? Hopefully. Please agree with me. So I had a zig, and then we had a zag. And then we had a zig, and then we had a zag. I got rid of the zigzag, zigzag, and now we just have one big zig and a little zag. That's the plan. And after I did that, it went a lot better. So we'll take this out. Uh-huh. Also, to add the bounce to the pattern, like we talked about before, we also have to add leaves, and we have to add coarse dirt to this other side in order for it to really feel right. So want to put that over here, maybe. Get some leaves. And yeah, you get the idea. All right, let's take a look from over here. How's it looking now? All right, that's not terrible. I can live with not terrible, right? Yeah. I think what I'll do... Yeah, let's do this. We're going to build up the terrain a little bit here. All the way around, and then make it connect to over here. Ah, darn it. I still have a bucket of milk, though. We're good. Well, there we go, guys. So we bounced out our pattern here. We got all this garbage on the left side as well. The leaves, the grass, coarse dirt. And by doing that, it looks a lot more pleasing, right? Or at least I think it does anyway. You can share your own opinion in the comments. I've also finished mixing in the cobblestone and andesite over here. You'll notice when I do this, I start with the gravel first, like the soft material. Or if I'm working with dirt and like clay, I'll start with the dirt first. You don't want to do cobblestone and then add gravel because it takes longer to break cobblestone. And it just goes quicker if you use the soft material as your base instead. Here's another really simple little trick I'll share with you guys. It's a pretty common one. If you have a plain Jane old fence like this, one way you can add more interest to it is by, like, every second block, get rid of the fence and put in a fence gate. And what that does is it has a slightly different texture, and it doesn't connect at the bottom. So it looks like this fence here is supporting it, and this is raised. It's also nice because you can exit out wherever you want that way, too. And you can see it pretty clearly here, too. Like, it's a simple thing, but it does change the look of the fence quite a bit, I would say. Uh-huh. Added some lily pads in our water here. One sugar cane. I would add more, but I don't want to go near the fishy up there. Elder Guardian keeps getting me. So I'm going to keep my distance for today. But yeah, I'm really liking this, guys. It's feeling pretty good. It has one problem. As some of you might be thinking, did Etho really spend the whole episode building this path that has no start or finish? And yeah, I did. It's true. So it's not super useful at the moment. What we got to do is bring it down. Oh, that's coarse dirt. That's the word I'm looking for. We want to bring this down kind of a gentle slope down to here and then connect to this. I don't like this trodden dirt. I don't know what I was thinking when I put it here. I don't know. But this is supposed to be a path as well. We'll probably have to change that. And my plan originally was to dig a tunnel through this hill. So we'll have a path going through a tunnel, which should look pretty cool. I love tunnels. Go through to the other side here. And eventually we might get around to building a path through this area too, which will hopefully connect to a village we build over here. We got one building made already. Kind of need like 10 more or so though to make it feel good. But this is our blacksmith building, and we have the purple smelting in the basement here. I am very bad at interior design. I don't do it very often, and like a lot of these buildings still need it. So that's another project to do. But that is going to have to wait until another time, guys, because I am out of time for today. And I just got a lag spike, and I realized I haven't shut off the potion brewing system since last time. That's been running this whole time. Oh, snap. All right, so here's our comment of the day. It says, to those commenting that Etho should just change the game rule to fix his farm, you're not exactly wrong, but I don't think Etho's wanting to do that at all. Not just because it might be temporary either. Want to say first that I do think the cram limit is incredibly stupid and Mojang should definitely not keep it. So last episode, I talked a lot about the cramming limit rule. You can change it. You definitely can change it. Oops. Oh, did I overshoot? But as a general rule, I try not to change any of our game rules or any of the vanilla settings of our world here. The only time I've really gone against that is when I switched the world to Amplified a long time ago. And also, one time I tried... Or I thought about moving the spawn in my world, but I never did end up doing that for some reason. So yeah, it's pretty much a straight-up vanilla series here. Now, I did get a lot of support, though. A lot of people told me I should change this game rule, because I don't like it either myself. The max cramming rule seems a little stupid, so I might go ahead and just get rid of it. I'm not sure. We will see. I'll see what you guys say again. If you have any... If any of you have any strong feelings that I shouldn't do that, let me know in the comments. Uh-huh. Also, something I've been thinking would be fun is if we tried a texture pack in our world here, just to see how it's different. Not to use regularly, but just as a, you know, what does our world like look like with a texture pack? That might be a fun thing to do. We will see. All right, guys, so... Until next time, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you have a wonderful day. And I'll see you in the next episode. Take care. Bye-bye.